Want to thank all the people who have made this day happen, not just today, but through the years, because it is about raising awareness that we are going to start to address the stigma and start to make it's a huge shift that we're talking about in terms of how people communicate with each other and how people respond and support each other. And I think that if we continue to have everybody in our community saying yes, I will be part of the solution, that we're going to make a difference. I want to acknowledge, as Sharon said, that today is a day of remembrance. Just since January, 909 people have lost their lives to overdose, and that's 909 too many. And there were thousands more before that, and every one of them have left behind friends, and family, people who cared about them, and are often driven to action. Driven to action to see change and to bring people into the fold so that they are no longer being kept on the outside in the dark. In 2017, the first overdose awareness day here in the Comox Valley was organized by the Hedekins. John was actually one of the first people that I ever met in my office after I was newly elected. And he talked about the loss of his son, whose name was Ryan, who was 27 years old. And at the time, my son is named Ryan. He was 27 years old, and I couldn't imagine the pain of losing him. And that helped prompt me to start talking more about it and being more committed to seeing change. And I know that when we were form government on July 18th in 2017. And on that day, our premier initiated the first mental health and addictions ministry in Canada. Unfortunately, that still continues today, but this is, he appointed Judy Darcy, the MLA from New Westminster, and she has been relentless in 24/7 working to see change. And there's been so many different initiatives that have been undertaken, and as we were starting to see some success in 2019, the reduction of overdose was 39%. So it was going in a better direction. It wasn't over, and it isn't totally solved. But then COVID hit, and the challenges that everyone is facing are more than doubled. For people who are fighting addiction, the isolation, the lack of contact, and the toxic drug supply that has hit our streets is from the closing of the borders has been a devastating time. And so I want to say such a big thank you to everyone who has tried to support their family members through this time. Family members, people who are working in the addictions field, mental health and addiction support people, all of the health practitioners who are out there helping, all of the organizations, like as was mentioned, AIDS Vancouver Island. I know that we see the nursing centers is very involved. I see faces out here today that I have seen over the years who are still there. You haven't burnt out, thank you. Thank you, Amanda. I think that it's important that we continue to support each other and lift each other up as we move forward so that we can see less names on these banners. I'd like to stop now and just say that I would like to acknowledge the last words that came out of in a press statement from our minister. She said, International Overdose Awareness Day is a day to remember that the overdose crisis touches each one of us. It is a day when we say loudly and clearly that addiction is not a moral failing, it is a health issue that should be treated like any other health issue, with consideration, caring, and respect. And I want you to know that our government is committed to continuing on this path. We haven't, as she says, as Judy says, we haven't taken our foot off the gas through this time. And we need your support. We recognize that we get through this together. And I thank you so much. And if I could, I'd give you a big hug to share the day and the pain and the grief and the hope for tomorrow. Thank you, everyone.
Right on.